I mean, it was about 2000, 2001, for all those years from 2000 to like, you know, maybe 2009 when I was with the Angels. I've heard it a couple times with the Angels. But just the one time is when I saw kids, you know, saying it and kind of chanting that word. And I had to turn around. I've heard it a lot, but I had to turn around because I heard children's voice. And I was just pointing up there to tell them, hey, tell those kids to stop saying that word. And they just pulled their, you know, put their hands up and did like this and told me to turn around or whatever. So they kind of, you know, allow those kids to say it. And these are grownups are telling me to turn around. So I kind of turned around and just like, this is crazy. And at that little moment right there, maybe it was a temporary situation, but it made a permanent scar or mark in me that I don't want to play here. You know, it went from, man, I'm in Fenway Park, I love it here, to I don't want to play here. So it wasn't the Red Sox. It wasn't the organization. It wasn't just Boston fans. It was just those group of people there that did not hold those kids accountable. And I always say, those kids, I always think about, where are they? Are they in politics? Are they police chief? Are they CEOs of big companies? And now I know they have hate in their heart because no one stopped them early and explained to them why is that that's such a harsh word. Now they might have hate in their heart and discriminate against people my skin color wherever they are in leadership. So I hope they're not in leadership, but they could be.
You had a no trade clause in your contract to Boston?
Yeah, I had in some places 20 teams and the other places 10 or 15 teams or whatever it may be. But Boston was always one of those teams. I've had numerous discussions with David Ortiz and wanted me to come and play 1 year. But we just had a discussion about it. It wasn't anything final. He just asked me, what about it? And he kind of knows, since we were played together forever, he knows the situation. He knows it well. But, you know, I had to put it in there because I saw my family walking amongst those people and, you know, that actually say those things and believe in those things. And if you allow it to happen as grownups for kids, and I thought that would be bad for my family. My family's Black, you know. And, you know, they're walking around, you know, somewhere, Newberry Street or anything, and they happen to hear that or get discriminated on, you know, I'm going to be pretty upset. And I don't want to be that guy. I don't want to be the angry Black guy, you know. So I just kind of eliminated the whole thing itself. When I told my wife that it happened, and she was kind of upset about it and never wanted to come either. So